Hi, I'm Paul from Google, and today we're going to show you how to build a Google app compatible banner in Google Web Designer. If you don't have Google Web Designer installed, visit the site to download it for free. Now that you have it installed, go ahead and open it up. You can create a new blank banner, start from a pre-built customizable template, or open an existing file you've already created. For this video, let's create something from scratch. Under Environment, make sure to select Google Ads. If you select any other option other than Google Ads, your creative will not upload correctly. Give it a name. This can be anything you want. Set the destination folder, set your dimensions, and choose either quick or advanced animation mode. Finally, click OK to create your ad. If this is the first time you're using Google Web Designer, I highly recommend you check out the YouTube channel and visit their help center to get more familiar with the tool. To start, I'm going to draw out a new div and give it a blue background color. Let's use a custom font from Google Cloud Fonts. Select the text tool and click the Add Fonts icon at the top. This brings up a list of available Cloud Fonts I can use. Visit the Google Cloud Font site to see even more details about each font and find the right one for your ad. Let's search for Roboto and choose Roboto Slab by selecting it. Now it's available in the Fonts dropdown. Drag out a text box area and type some text. Let's adjust the font size to make it larger and change the color to white. And let's make it bold and center it. Great, looking good. Next, let's add an image in our creative by dragging it from our local folder onto our page. I've already compressed this image, so it's as small as possible while retaining the quality I want. I'll switch on the transform controls and resize it down to fit. Then move it into place and use stage align controls to get it centered. Perfect. Now let's add our call to action button. Let's make a new div for our button, but let's add some rounded corners. Adjust the border radius to your liking and draw out a button area. Now let's give it a background color and move it into position. Finally, I'll add some text over our button. Now let's add some animation. We can easily add animation by transitioning between different scenes. When you make a new scene, it captures the current position and properties of everything on our page. For more information on creating animations, see the Google Web Designer Help Center. I want the main headline text to fade and slide in. To accomplish this, I'll first move the text area down and then adjust the opacity property to 0. This will be the beginning state of my animation. Then I create a new scene by clicking the Add Scene button. This new scene will be the end of our animation, so I'll put the text back in its final spot and adjust the opacity to 1. Now I can click play to view the animation. Now we're done. Let's preview and then publish. Click the preview button to view your ad in a browser. We see the text slide and fade in. Go back to Google Web Designer and choose publish locally. On the Publish screen, we can verify the settings look good and click Publish to create a zip of our creative. This can now be uploaded directly to Google Ads. For more information, please watch the video on uploading to Google Ads. In this video, we showed you how to create a new banner from scratch using Google Web Designer. We added some quick animations that look great. The output is ready to go in your Google Ads campaign. Thanks for watching.